Over 300 teams start the season with hopes of making it to the NCAA tournament, but only 64 lucky teams received an invitation. These teams start their journey down the road to the Final Four in today's game between the Texas A&M Aggies and the Iowa Hawkeyes.
This place is rocking and rolling, baby!
The Hawkeyes might be in over their heads in this one, Dick.
Absolutely. Here are some things that they have to do if they're going to have a chance to win. First, the point guard has to be the leader out there. He's got to be the coach on the floor. Secondly, don't let him rain threes from the arc, baby. Finally, don't let turnovers decide the game. Protect the ball. Take care of the basketball.
Well, partner, I say let's get to the action on the court, and we'll see how this one plays out.
It's a block party out there.
He keeps the dribble as they reset. The power forward with the ball. He pump fakes. The shooting guard takes the feed.
Steal, go up the other way, get a layup.
They move it into the front court. Looking for the foul.
Nice job of using the screen to get open for that good shot.
Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. Here's a spin down in the low block.
I think he's got a variety of moves. Use the sky hook, the jump hook, and add a spin move to the goal.
Trying to pack it inside. Number 34 with the fake. On the dribble, gives it up. Inside. I want to thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. He attempts a jump hook and off the mark. He'll regroup the offense. The shooting guard takes the pass. Way off target. Inside.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
They're lighting it up from the field right now, Dick.
They're in a dangerous rhythm, my friend.
Dangerous?
Dangerous for the defense if they keep it up.
On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. On the inside. That one, there should have been a foul called, I think.
Well, you take a look right there. I thought there was contact grab on the defensive player.
That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
Shows patience waiting for the reset. With the catch, nice execution on the spin.
I tell you, great spin move to the basket.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, guys, both teams seem to be playing very conservative. We're still waiting for one of these teams to throw the first punch, guys.
The center gets the pass. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
The center gets the ball. Trying to draw the foul. Are they confused about who goes where on that double team?
Oh, there's no doubt.
Moving it around the perimeter. Fed the low block. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works. That's basic.
Now the high screen. Off the rim and no good.
Nice job to create the angle using the glass.
2-for-1 opportunity.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
leaning in, trying to draw contact. Drops the bucket despite the harm. Shot clock is dead. They work it around the perimeter. Trying to pack it inside. Jumps into the defender. Basket falls despite the contact. Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot.
From way outside, way off target. At halftime, the Hawkeyes are trailing by six. Well, it's been a close one so far, Dick Vitale. What's your take on the play of the half?
Check out some of the inside play we witnessed in the first half. We saw some great baskets down low, which really opened up the outside range for both teams.
All right, Dick, let's get back to the action as the two teams are just about ready to start the second half. Iowa just couldn't seem to stop turning the ball over in that first half, Dick.
Hey, if you ask me, these guys haven't clued on the magnitude of this game yet. They need to take care of the ball from here on in, or they have no shot, and they'll be running lots of laps tomorrow in practice.
He puts it in with contact and all. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
All right, thanks, Aaron. This is just great hustle and great defense of the steal.
I'll tell you what, they telegraphed that pass, and he read it perfectly defensively as a post player.
Time to pick up the defense here now. Picks off the pass. Gave it up. He shoots from the angle. Off the rim and no good. Dick, they really need to get something going in a hurry here.
Yeah, call a timeout and get your boys into the game, Brad.
Here's the three ball. He nails the shot. Playing for the steal in the post, and he didn't get it.
Okay, tried to make the spectacular play, but now he's embarrassed.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, the battle in the paint has played a major factor in this game and is probably some of the reason why they have this lead. If things don't change in a hurry, this game could get ugly, guys.
I think she's right about that, Richie.
Oh, I don't think there's any doubt about it, Brad. We've said so many times, you know, great post play, you got a chance really to win.
There appears to be a mismatch in the post.
Can they get him the ball, though?
Dickie's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Tries for two. They still don't score. He throws up the shot. Scorches the net.
He may be in trouble here, Brad.
Goes up for two. Doesn't go. The Hawkeyes are becoming regulars at the national tournament.
Hey, Brad, once you have this reputation, everything seems to fall into place. Recruiting becomes easier. The alumni starts to get involved. You appear on ESPN. Things just start to roll. He used the screen to create the space for the score on the inside.
Doesn't get much better than this in an NCAA tournament game. A close first half. The second half is more of the same, and Dick, it's going to come down to the final few possessions.
Hey, Brad, I think this is going right to the finish line with the last possession. Whoever gets the ball last, I think, is going to win this baby. I mean, they're making every big shot, both these clubs.
Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
On the outside.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Holt receives the pass. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Can't get a shot off in time, Dick.
They couldn't get a shot off because they wasted too much time getting set up.
For two, and in and out. Bland is animated and ready to go.
He may be in the zone right now, Brad.
Too physical. You talk about a great drive. How about the State Farm drive of the game?
I tell you, he was explosive. He was up, up, and away. What a drive to the rack, baby. That was special.
I got to be sure they'll continue to look to foul here, Dick. How's the front court productivity tonight, Dick?
You know, Brad, basketball is a big man's game. If you have a few on your team and are active and energetic, it makes your team that much better. Ultimately, you want all of your players to be productive, but an inside presence will separate your team from others.
Foul, and that stops the clock again.
Nobody likes this part of the game when the losing team is fouling in order to stop the clock.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Brad, I think they'll continue to do so in an attempt to get back in the ballgame. They should look to foul the opponent's weakest free throw shooter.
And the clock stopped with a foul. Oh, and look at the crowd and look at the reaction.
I tell you, the home fans are going crazy. There's jubilation.
He'll have one plus one if it's good. It's good. Hits the second. They call for a T.O., Dick.
Hey, time is their worst enemy at this point, Brad. They're going to have to bear down and get some stops, then convert at the other end.
Coming out of the timeout, I'd expect we're going to see more focused play on both sides.
One would assume so.
9 points is the difference now.
A difference that can change in a heartbeat if you ain't careful, Brad.
He shoots from the top of the key. He's money with a shot. And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here.
Hey, Brad, you want to get to the line early and often. You end up getting your opponents into foul trouble, and it's also an opportunity to get some points.
Sinks it. And, Dick, that puts the lead at 9.
9 points is surmountable. This is the time to start jacking threes.
He draws a foul. Oh, and you can tell by the look on his face, he wasn't expecting the whistle on him.
Wow, look at the facial expression. He says, me?
It's a 9-point lead.
Well, 9 points still keeps you in the game, though, Brad. They can't have a breakdown here, though. And now he finds right away, head up, hit the head up, find the open guy, give it up, give the rock up.
Great defense. He attempts the trifecta, rims out. Holt handles the feed. Ball was tipped loose, but the offense retains possession. A whistle and a foul, and the coach not happy on the sideline. That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
He goes to the line. He makes the front end of the 1-1. Dick, they're really getting it done from the line tonight, aren't they?
And a surprisingly collective effort, Brad.
He hits the second shot. They have found their stroke at the stripe tonight, Dick.
This has always been an excellent free throw shooting bunch.
Dick, I think the better team won. We can say that. And it's heartbreak for the other club. But, you know, you got to win it. Keep on going to get to that final Monday night in April.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about. And that was the difference in the game.
Texas A&M came, they saw, and they conquered their first-round foe, Dick.
I tell you, Brad, watch out for this team because the coach has these kids playing with more intensity than they ever did during a regular season. And I'm going to tell you, it's going to serve them well as now they shift into gear for that second-round matchup.
It's been a fun game, and as always,